Taipei, where it's raining pretty heavily. But we're going to be making our way to the island of Okinawa, Japan. Capital of Okinawa, with the nice city of Naha. Hope you guys enjoy this flight. Should be more than about 2 hours. That's okay. We've seen worse. We've seen worse rain than this. There was something in Asia. Frankly, we only had rain, which is unfortunate, but that's okay. So we've got all our clearances. Make our way to the gate there to get on the runway.
Tower Boss 202201 ready for departure runway 10 IFR to Naha AFB.
Boss 202201 QNH, 2 Niner Decimal, 411084 at 24. Cleared for takeoff runway 10.
Cleared for takeoff runway 10, Boss 202201. Going to 124.6, Boss 202201. Taipei Center, Boss 202201 is at 1,200 feet, climbing 9,000 feet.
Boss 202201, Taipei Center, QNH 29 decimal 41, continue to SITSA as planned.
Alright, back to the rain. That's okay, alright, let's climb in here. Hopefully we'll be over these clouds. Everything will be good. We are fighting 30 to 20. Yeah, so we are fighting the wind here as we're going up. That's okay. Won't need to collapse anymore. Yeah, we're almost at 40 knots behind here. It says we're at the air speed is going at 188, but our ground speed is 150. Yeah. We are fighting the wind. And that is some heavy rain. Us being shaken up like that. The autopilot is pretty great there. You have the controller with the way it is? We are definitely being tossed around. We have no passenger, or else we'd be probably complaining of all this shaking. And our airspeed needle went crazy. Well, it's getting cut right there, and there's no more.
Off 202201 climb and maintain 17,000 feet.
Climb and maintain 17,000 feet, Boss 202201.
Got some lightning there, huh? As you can see, Okinawa isn't that far off. We're gonna make it just fine once we're at altitude. I'll bring down the throttle there, and the little few lines are gonna go way out there. Be directly to Tokyo. Well, Tokyo is pretty important. We left here Taiwan and we're going to Okinawa, which is... So, Okinawa is right there at Furuha, right? Now, Tokyo, on the other hand, there. So it's one, two, four times further. So if this is going to take us about 2 hours, getting to Tokyo would actually take us about a good 8 hours. This plane doesn't have the fuel for that. So we're going to go to Okinawa. And we're probably going to head up. That, or we're just gonna hit the big island right around here, there, and then head to South Korea, and then we can figure out what to do. Okay. But for now, we're just gonna stick right there and head towards Naha in Okinawa, which is one of the most southern islands in Japan, I think. Somewhere. Hopefully it is. As you can see, I've added the flag of Taiwan. Aha! Next flag will be a giant white one with a red dot in the middle. Japan.
Off 202201 climb and maintain flight level 250. Climb and maintain flight level 250, Boss 202201.
There we go, look at that, how beautiful that is. Defrost on. Right there. Put that away pretty fast. There we go. It's all gone. Okay. Good. Bit unrealistic either with that. Other than the wind blowing us sideways right now, 24 knots. Pretty good. 47 ground speed.
Off 202201 climb and maintain flight level 270. Climb and maintain flight level 270, Boss 202201.
I guess our cruising altitude will be 270. To reach there, I'm gonna pull back the gas here. Bring it down to 550 gallons per hour, which I'd really like to have it at, and we'll be all good. Not in the rain. around 20 minutes now. Our climb complete would actually go pretty fast. I gotta find some royal music. Like, you guys don't hear it, but I hear my music. That's it. But I made sure that we go to the video here. Because last time I did that video, it actually got copyright flagged, even though it's a copyright free music. Weird, but better. But I will have to find something. I want you guys to have a bit of music there. Right along with me. Huh. I can actually see the tail. Built in there to stabilize behind us. The other window. This side, but if I can see the wing here, I can see the wing there, but if you look at the back window there, it's stabilizing from the back. Wow. Never noticed that. officers are gone. Tell me that the inner separator is gone. I prefer to go a little higher. It's not cut in a straight line anymore. But after this little patch of red in front of us, we're going into green, so maybe we'll land. But now we'll cut that all. Here's hope. There. We got a little less than an hour left to go. Good. Check the weather right over here. Let it pilot me. There we go. Weather radar. On. That is true, it does that now. Awesome. So the way it works, it doesn't show clouds anymore, it shows rain. So if we put it back to the forest, in front of us there's rain, but not clouds. Oh, that is so nice. So the next rad, cloud cover. That's what we have on the left screen here. And the right side, the weather radar, shows us rain. Awesome. So if I were to check red, I could find a red problem. But if I want to know if any rain in front of us, alright, let's do something here before I forget. So we are going to Roja. And we want the frequency ILS 30. there, and then the dog and business. Yeah. But we have less than an hour to go. 6 minutes. And everything is going good and according to plan. Getting a little bit of a swing there. Get what little ice we have off.
Boss 202201, contact NAHA AFB Center on 123.9er. Good day.
Going to 123.9er, Boss 202201. NAHA AFB Center, Boss 202201, flight level 270.
Boss 202201, NAHA AFB Center, continue as planned.
Let's go read on Wikipedia. Alright, so we are going to Okinawa Island. Alternatively, Okinawa, Kinemon, Gina, Inigami, Shinta. Okay, it's the largest of the Okinawa Island. Island of Japan in the Kyushu region. It is the smallest and the least populated of the five main islands of Japan. The island is approximately 100 kilometers long and an average 11 kilometers wide. It has an area of 1,250 square kilometers and is roughly 640 kilometers south of the main island of Kyushu with the rest of Japan. And that's why we weren't going straight to. It's still pretty far. The greater Naha area has roughly 800,000 residents, but the city itself has about 320,000. Naha is the seat of Okinawa Prefecture on the southwestern part of Okinawa Island. Okinawa has a humid subtropical climate. Now, if you ever watch any Japanese shows or anime or whatnot, you'll notice that whenever they go on vacation, you know, like, here in Canada, from Quebec, people usually go to Mexico, or they go to Cuba, or Dominican Republic, you know, the Caribbean. Well, they, according to most of their shows, they just go south to Okinawa. That's like their version of the Caribbean. So they have beaches, it's warm. I want to see the beaches. We're going to go see some beaches. At least try to find some home there. Okay. What did they got to say about? Okinawa has been critical. Strategic location of the United States Armed Forces. Battle of Okinawa and the end of World War II, really. The island was under American administration until 1972. Oh, that I didn't know. And today hosts around 26,000 U.S. military personnel, about half of the full complement of the United States Forces in Japan. Wow, they have like 50,000 people. 50,000 military personnel in Japan. Now was the fifth largest island. Do that. The straight line distance is about 160 kilometers. Since 1972, over 1,000 hectares of land reclamation. Cool. All right, climate. That's what I'm going to talk about. The island has a humid subtropical. Sorry about that. The island has a humid subtropical climate bordering on the tropical rainforest climate. The island sports a dense northern forest of rainy season that occurring in the late spring. Why not? They even talk about the U.S. military. Let's see here. The United States maintains American military bases in Japan as part of the U.S.-Japan Alliance in 1951. I don't know if you would call it an end of World War II, you know, it was the occupation of Japan, of course, and the U.S. They don't want it happening again. But is it really an alliance, or they just stay there? That's what I'm wondering. Anyways, that's what I thought. Most of the U.S. military are in Okinawa Prefecture. In 2015, there were approximately 50,000 U.S. military personnel stationed in Japan, 40,000 dependent on 5,500 American civilians employed by the United States Department of Defense. About 26,000 of the military personnel are on Okinawa Island. There are 32 United States military bases on Okinawa Island. 32? Really? On that little thing? Wow. Approximately 62% of all U.S. bases in Japan are on the They cover 25% of Okinawa Island. So 25% of the whole area of the island is each. Major bases are Denma, Kadena, Hansen, Tori, Schwab, Foster, and Cooper. Wow, Okinawa at one point hosted approximately 1,200 nuclear warheads. Wow. There were several nuclear weapon incidents in Okinawa near the island. That's not good. In 1971, Okinawa Reservation Agreement officially ended the U.S. military occupation of Okinawa. That's, there you go, that's what I was saying. Occupation. Since 51, it wasn't an alliance, it was an occupation. Bases primarily exist to serve Japanese and American strategic interests, but are unpopular with most local residents. Gee, I wonder why you got a foreign military in your backyard. Despite recent efforts to move the bases out of the core area following incidents involving military personnel and resulting in protests, including the 1995 Okinawa rape. Yeah, let's go. Okinawa has various historical buildings and monuments such as feudal castles, ruins, pesto, and other historical. Shuri Castle, the most famous castle in Okinawa, and a UNESCO World Heritage. Maybe we'll go see that. Nakagusuku Castle is the Kusuku village of Kitanakagusuku, Okinawa. Kitanakagusuku is In this UNESCO World Heritage Site, one of the 100 things has the cornerstone of peace, and to remember the Battle of Okinawa at the end of World War II. Nearby is the Okinawa Prefecture Peace Memorial. Well, why not? Stuff. So yeah, that's where we're going. We're gonna try to find some beaches. Maybe see if we can find those castles. Stuff. That's the plan, anyways. Alright, how much time left? About 45 minutes left to go. Oh, we had a much better view before in the clouds than just, well, above the clouds than in the clouds. A lot of ice. Rainy red spot decimated quite a lot. Actually, it seems like we're never catching up to anything. This is good since we've taken off and are crossing our fingers here. They haven't reported us being at the wrong altitude at all, so...
Boss 202201, contact Nova AFB Center on 119.3. Good day.
Yeah, thanks for interrupting. 119.3.
Going to 119.3, Boss 202201. Naha AFB Center, Boss 202201, flight level 270.
Boss 202201, Naha AFB Center, continue as planned.
Okay, what was I saying? I don't remember what I was saying. Ah, buoy. They interrupted my line of thought. Oh well, speaking. record this in one go, so no cuts, no nothing. It is what it is. It ain't much, but it's something. I don't like flying between the clouds. Yeah, it's quite fun, actually. guys, look at that. We are going Mach 0.5. We are going half. I heard there was a developer that making the Concorde for a flight simulator for all you people out there. I mean, we're supposed to get the F-18, but because the new Top Gun movie got pushed back to here in March, the F-18, the free F-18 from Microsoft Flight Simulator also got pushed back. I really wonder if it's going to be any good with the Top Gun. Now the old one with the hidden camera and all that. It was good. I liked it because at the time I was a kid, there were military planes. Shot down, all that stuff. But generally speaking, Top Gun didn't get super high rating. If I remember well, it was like almost 70% IMDb database. And even Rotten Tomatoes was like under 60%, if I remember well. And quite frankly, the story was okay. And now people are going to bash on me because but what really caught my attention when I was a kid, right? It was the plane. It was all the flying and the guns, all that stuff. I couldn't care less that he fell in love with a civilian instructor. I was a kid. Seeing those F-14s do what they were doing, that was cool. Now the new one, are they gonna like try to remake the same story? I don't know. Literally, the story is not what got me hooked on Top Gun again. Hopefully the story is gonna get. I'm a bit more story driven than action kid. Definitely the planes are going to be plus. If you want a good, if you watch any anime, like I tend to watch anime, certain types of anime, Yukikaze, it's all about futuristic AI. I really like that. The Cross theory, the first planes were inspired by the F-14, I guess. They look very similar, for sure. Cross Zero was really cool. Like, of course, as the years go by, the animation gets way better and more technical and everything. Story itself, though, the whole singing thing, okay, cool. Like, I know the Japanese going through a sort of cultural revolution, anti-war thing. Understandable. But we could say that it's a little girl singing that saved the world. Saved the world. Oh no, the world actually got trashed. The world didn't get saved at all. My favorite of the Macross series, I would have to say, is probably Macross Plus, followed by Hero Real. Really, really, really close. Like, I love the planet. And I also really like the planes on the cross, plus I guess it was really the planes that got me into those shows too. What I really liked was the piloting of the YF-20. It was the 20. Just had to sit there and it would read your mind and interpret what you wanted it to do and do it. Kind of got him in hot water though at one point, because pissed off and kind of trashed the plane, the other guy. Yeah. All in all, it made his reaction really, really fast. You were starting to see the ocean down there. Good, good. That's a good sign. Oh, look at that. I don't know if you guys can see it through the clouds and everything, but I see an island. I see some turquoise water and beaches. Yeah. I see the beach. We're gonna go to the beach. I really can't visit too many more countries. I have room for one more room on that, and that's it. I'm gonna have to start putting some on the other one. I don't want to. I'm gonna keep
going. Boss 202201, descend and maintain 15,000 feet.
Descend and maintain 15,000 feet, Boss 202201.
Alright, starting our descent. That looks good. This is good. It's like cloudy, but clear enough as we get to it. Great. Oh yeah, we can see the island there through the cloud. Look at those. What are those? Wow, you can see the turquoise water. That's beautiful. That is really something awesome. That's one thing they gotta fix now is all the I think there's just too much lightning going on. Like, this is not lightning weather. Why did we just get huge lightning? Unless I'm mistaken, it's lightning all the time in the clouds that we don't see at all on the ground. I've never seen, you know, just a cloudy day and with sunshine and everything. Not a problem in the world, and then just lightning out of the blue. Yeah, it's kind of weird. Again, behind the sort of see the island. There it is. There's Okinawa, boys and girls. We're going to the beach. Clouds over the north there, but that's not where we're going, and we're going to be landing somewhere over there. Oh yeah, this is perfect weather to come in and land. I'm liking it. But the ice on the wing should be melting off.
Boss 202201, descend and maintain 9,000 feet.
Descend and maintain 9,000 feet, Boss 202201.
Going down quickly. gonna go a lot faster going down than we are going up. Here you can see the boom, the waves, and the water. If you guys can see it on YouTube, there's the progression between you guys and the Muslims. I'll have a clue, but in game, it's the waves. It's pretty awesome. There it is, boys and girls. Oh, and now, the beaches. U.S. Army.
Boss 202201, contact Naha AFB approach on 119.65. Good day.
For Boss 202201. Naha AFB approach, Voss 202201 9,000 feet.
Voss 202201 Naha AFB approach QNH 29.74 continue as planned. Voss 202201 descend and maintain 2,000 feet.
Alright, already.
Descend and maintain 2,000 feet, Voss 202201.
We're going to be descending at a rate of 1,000 feet per minute.
Off 202201, you are 28 miles north. Maintain present heading and altitude. Expect ILS X-ray runway 36 right approach via November Hotel, Charlie 196 radio 150 DMER. Clear to November Hotel, Charlie.
What now?
Maintain present heading and altitude. Expect ILS X-ray runway 36 right approach via November Hotel Charlie 196 radial 150 DMER. Clear to November Hotel Charlie, Boss 202201.
QNH is there. She must be coming via 196. I understand that, but why does she want me to use the radio when I could be in the ALS? There's Okinawa! All this industrial area there, all that gray and all the green. That's Naha urban area. Greater urban area. This line should be. Yeah. There they are! Oh, the platform. Water here must be very clear. Deserted islands, but that would be great to go there with a boat and just relax on the beach. Look at that. That's so nice. I'm burning, feel like crazy right now. Are there any houses in the middle of the island or anything? Any place to shop? Awesome. You're on the other side, okay. I can see there's a town there, that's definitely a town, and there's some roads on the mountain. That's probably a golf course right there. They play golf in Japan? That's okay. Alright, we're almost at altitude. that's the exact same thing you do in DCS when you prepare to land on a carrier with the F-18. Let's say your carrier is there at ROA. Well, you would actually get near it as clearance, go around the thing, go back, and position yourself on the glide slope. We lost the same maneuver as we're doing right now. And then you just your turn, according to the air traffic controller, make your way down. And then at the end, all you have to do is connect to even that officer, member, or whatever that controls the little camera that tells you more power, less power, a little to the left, a little to the right, you know. Land on the wires there that'll grab you and not make you just take you off the boat. Yeah, I should make a video of that. You're on an aircraft carrier, there. I don't need the de-ice for the bird.
Boss 202201 climb and maintain 4,400 feet.
Climb and maintain 4,400 feet, Boss 202201.
Off 202201 descent and maintain 2,000 feet.
Really?
Descend and maintain 2,000 feet, Boss 202201.
She's lost. Boss, can you tell the air traffic controller she's going nuts? Up to 4,400, go back down to 2,000. Checklist for approach. Lights are on, everything's good here. We're not putting down the land here just yet. Switch over. Location 1, put it on approach. flap extended, maximum speed 198, takeoff at landing at landing gear at
Boss 202201, you are 11 miles south of Naha ASB. Contact Naha ASB Tower on 118.1 when inbound.
Tower on 118.1, Boss 202201. Naha AFB Tower, Boss 202201, 8 miles south inbound ILS X-ray runway 36 right approach.
Boss 202201, Naha AFB Tower. QNH 2 Niner Decimal 74 Wind 154 at Tree 2. Cleared ILS, X-ray runway 36 right approach.
Cleared ILS, X-ray runway 36 right approach, Boss 202201.
Boss 202201 Wind 154 at Tree 2. Cleared to land runway 36 right.
Cleared to land runway 36 right, Boss 202201.
We're not landing in the best of situations here. We got the wind back in this position. That's not ideal. So our ground speed is actually faster than our airspeed, so we're going to be landing pretty darn fast. Back end on the side, really not good. Now, I don't know what happened to us earlier there with that massive leg spike and beeping and everything. I really wish I knew what happened.
20201 exit, runway with Naval.
Oh, that was a very complex landing, but beautiful nonetheless.
Boss 202201, contact ground on 121.8.
One two one decimal eight for Boss 202201. Naha AFB ground, Boss 202201 taxi to parking.
Boss 202201 taxi to general aviation parking via taxiway Echo 5 Alpha 4.
Taxiing to general aviation parking using taxiway Echo 5 Alpha 4, Boss 202201.
So you guys are wondering, Echo 5 Alpha 4 is right there, 5A4. He wants us to use that taxiway to get general aviation parking. Alright.
Boss 202201, hold position, caution, other traffic.
Hold position, Boss 202201.
Boss 202201, continue taxi.
Roger, Boss 202201.
Well, guys, we've made it to Okinawa. We've made it to Naha. Sort of like the capital prefecture, if you want to call it that way. Do you see that landing? That should not be there. So, we're going to visit this place. Welcome to Japan, everyone. Hope you guys enjoyed this flight. And I'll see you guys.